everyone, it's Lisa Mears here for Pretty Pink Posh. Today I'm going to be making two cards using some products in the Pretty Pink Posh March 2022 Easter and Spring release. The first product I'm using is the Floral Background Stencil. I'm starting off by applying some pixie spray to the back of the stencil and then adhering the stencil to my cardstock. And the technique that I'm using today, I'm going to be using light and fluffy modeling paste. When using modeling paste, you want to make sure that you're using heavyweight cardstock. The cardstock should not be too thin because you will be adding paste to the cardstock. My cardstock is cut down to 4 1/8 inch by 5 3/8 inches. I'm using a palette knife to apply paste to the stencil. After applying the paste, I will use a larger scraper just to get a better coverage of all of that paste so that it covers all of the openings of my stencil. The scraper allows you to create a smooth, even finish, but if you don't use the scraper, it will enable you to have more of a textured finish. Once all of the openings of the stencil have been covered, I do scrape any of the excess modeling paste that's left behind on the scraper and on the palette knife back in the jar. When you are finished adding the modeling paste, make sure that you put your stencil immediately in some water and clean off all of the tools with some water. Here's a look at the dimension left behind on my cardstock from using that stencil. So while the modeling paste is still wet, I'm going to be using the Distress Embossing Glaze to add color to my background. I'm starting off with the Speckled Egg Embossing Glaze and sprinkling that at the bottom of my cardstock panel and then just shaking off the excess, and that excess I can return to the jar. The next color I'm going to add is the Salvaged Patina, so I'm going to add that in the middle of that background. And when I shake off the excess, I'm going to be certain that I don't shake it so that the excess goes over the previous color. And then I'm going to return that excess back to the jar. And then the last color I'm going to be using is the Broken China Embossing Glaze. So this one is a little bit darker, and I'm going to finish off that card panel by adding it to the white area and then just shaking off the excess. Again, making sure that I don't go over the other previous two colors. So this just gives me a nice blue-green gradient color to my background. Once I apply the embossing glaze, I will heat set that, and I will tell you that it will take a little while for this to dry because it's such a large background. You can already see all of that beautiful texture, shine, and color added to that background. Isn't that pretty? I love that. The next stencil that I'm going to be using is called Layered Butterflies. This is a three-layer stencil, so it allows you to create beautiful layered butterflies using different color inks. So here I'm taking a piece of Bristol Smooth cardstock that I cut down to 4 by 5 1/2. I'm going to add this first layered stencil. It's the shape of the butterfly. And I'm applying the Saltwater Taffy Distress Oxide ink all over the stencil. So all of the butterflies are going to be in this color. Now, if you wanted to section off your stencil and make your butterflies different colors, you can most certainly do that. So after I apply the Saltwater Taffy, I remove the first stencil, and then I'm going to apply the second stencil. I'm just going to hold it down with some magnets while I apply the Candied Apple Distress Oxide ink. So it's a very similar color, only a little bit darker than the Saltwater Taffy, so it'll just bring out some of the accents in the wings. And with that stencil still in place, I'm using a Distress Embossing Dabber. This just applies some clear embossing ink to the openings on that stencil. You do not have to do this step. You can simply leave the ink as is and move on to the next layer. But I'm going to be using some embossing glaze to make these wings have some sparkle. And to do so, I'm going to next apply the Saltwater Taffy Embossing Glaze over top of my cardstock layer. So I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle that over the entire background. And it's only going to stick to where that embossing ink is on my background. Now, if you didn't have an embossing dauber, you could always use an embossing ink pad and it would do the same thing. So next, after I sprinkle on the glaze, I'm going to use my heat tool and heat set that. And that creates a nice sparkly, shiny finish on those butterfly wings. Next, I'm adding my third layered stencil. This is the middle part of the butterfly. And I'm going to be using the Salvaged Patina ink. And after I start applying this, I realize that it's a little bit too light to go over top of the saltwater taffy ink. So now I'm just going to pull out a darker ink. This is the Peacock Feathers Distress Oxide ink, and I'm just going to go over top of the stencil with this ink. And then when I pull that stencil up, you'll be able to see the beautiful teal and peachy color of those butterflies. So look at that beautiful background. You can see how those wings had some sparkle by using that embossing glaze. I think it turned out so pretty. So now I'm going to take these backgrounds and make some cards. So for my first card, I am making a shaker card using this butterfly shaker die set from Pretty Pink Posh. I die cut 6 of the butterflies using this peachy color cardstock, and I'm going to adhere one to my background just using some glue. I am going to take an acrylic block and just hold that down just to keep that down so that it sticks really well. I also die cut a butterfly out of this teal cardstock, but I'm only using the inside pieces. So I'm going to go ahead and add those inside pieces to the butterfly wings in that dark teal cardstock. Next, I'm going to glue down 4 more of those peach colored butterflies directly to the top of the one that's already on my card panel. And the reason I'm doing this is because I'm trying to build up the walls of the butterfly to hold my shaker bits inside. So once again, in total, I glued 4 butterflies to the base of the card. Now I'm adding glue to a 5th butterfly, and I'm going to add that to a piece of acetate. Once I have it added to the acetate, I'm going to take my scissors and I'm just going to trim around the butterfly to cut off the excess acetate. This butterfly layer is going to go over top of all of the shaker pieces to hold them inside. Next, I'm going to set the butterfly aside that has the acetate on it, and I'm ready to fill my butterfly shape that's adhered to the card with some shaker pieces. And I'm using the Sparkling Clear Confetti Mix from Pretty Pink Posh. This confetti mix is pretty flat, but I do want to mention that if your sequins or confetti mix or whatever you're putting inside of here is thicker than what I'm using, you may need to use more than 4 butterflies as the base of your shaker piece. So if your shaker bits are thicker, you'll just need to die cut some more butterflies and add to the base. So now I'm just adding some glue to the butterfly that's attached to the card, and then I'm going to put the butterfly die cut that has the acetate on it directly over top, and that will enclose all of those confetti pieces so now they are secure inside. Next, I'm going to take my last butterfly die cut piece. I'm just adding some ink to the edges because I want a little bit more dimension and depth on that butterfly. And then I just put some glue on the center part of the butterfly's body and just attach the center part so that the wings are able to stand up. And again, that gives more dimension to the butterfly. So for the sentiment, I'm using the Smile Script Word Die from Pretty Pink Posh. I die cut it out of black cardstock as well as the same peach cardstock that the butterfly was die cut from, and I just layered them together. So the peach is underneath and then the black is on top, and I just offset them just a little bit, and then I just added the dot from the die for the word smile, and then I'm adding that to a black piece of cardstock that measures 4 1/8 by 5 3/8. And then I'll add that to a white A2 size card base. And then I'm going to take my Spectrum Sparkle Clear pen. This is just a glitter pen, and I'm just adding some of the glitter on the butterfly wings just to add some sparkle. And then I'm going to add the Blue Sky Pearls to the center of the butterfly. And to finish off this card, I'm going to take some of the Sparkling Clear Confetti Mix and add some to the centers of the flowers on that stenciled background. And that will complete my first card. I just love how you can use this butterfly shaker die. Turn your butterfly into a shaker, and you can also add some dimension with those wings. Okay, so moving on, I'm going to use the second background that I created, and this time I'm going to use the butterfly die, but I'm not going to be making it into a shaker. So if you're not into shaker cards, you can still use this die without it being a shaker. I die cut a scalloped circle die from white cardstock. I'm using both the outside frame and the inside centerpiece, and I glued them onto my card base. I die cut the butterfly shaker die out of some dark teal cardstock, and I'm only adding the center of the butterfly to the card. I wanted those wings to remain popped up, and I'm adding another butterfly right on top. So I have two layers of the butterfly die, both attached in the center only. So that way I can flip those wings up and have all of that beautiful dimension. For the sentiment, I am stamping out "Sending you love and sunshine" onto some black cardstock using some clear embossing ink. I did put some powder on that cardstock prior to stamping out the image, just because when I do my embossing, I want to make sure that the embossing powder doesn't stick where there is no embossing ink. So now I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle some white embossing powder and then just flick off the excess, and then I'll heat set that. This sentiment is from the Pretty Pink Posh Hugs stamp set. So after I heat emboss that with the white embossing powder, I do trim it down, and then I just add it below the butterfly on the card front, and then I add some of the sparkling clear confetti mix to the center of the butterfly, and then I'll add this card layer to a teal piece of cardstock that measures 4 1/8 by 5 3/8. That's the same teal cardstock that I die cut the butterfly with, so it matches. And then it's added to an A2 size card base, and that completes that card. So here's a look at the two cards I created using these fun new products from Pretty Pink Posh. All product links will be down in the description box below. If you like this video, please click that thumbs up button. Thanks so much for watching, and have a great day. Bye-bye.